Cold weather can be hazardous to your health. Tonight at 5, we talked about the risks of hypothermia. Now, News 4's Kim Quintero joins us with a more common danger, icy slips and falls. And Kim, you had your own incident last winter, didn't you?
I sure did. It was our first snow in the upstate of the year. It melted and refroze into a sheet of ice. And when I opened my car door, let's just say my bottom became good friends with the pavement. And doctors say ice is a common cause of injury. Frostbite is also a concern.
Old man winter is making a comeback in the Western Carolinas. Thursday morning, ice covered bridges and overpasses, and public works crews pulled out the sanders. While cars got a little traction, it's the rest of us who are in danger of a slippery disaster.
You know, that's kind of the classic example. You just walk out early in the morning to get your newspaper and not realize that your front porch is frozen.
Dr. Jim Ellis, medical director of MD360 in Greenville, says bone fractures and head injuries from falls are common winter accidents.
That's a critical time to be very, very careful with your footing and, you know, close short steps rather than longer strides.
With overnight lows across the region expected to dive into the 20s again starting Sunday night, prolonged exposure can cause hypothermia and even frostbite.
Usually that can be taken care of, but it can lead to amputation of digits and even nose and ears and things like that.
So layers, layers, and more layers become dire for those active outdoors.
This is a synthetic and wool blend sock.
Jay Ferguson of Half Moon Outfitters of Greenville says it's important to keep your body warm, starting with a base of clothing made from fibers that will wick away sweat.
It's really going to help to regulate your body temperature on the core.
Since heat is also lost through the head, a beanie or hat is important. As the chill sets in, the key is prevention for a healthy and happy season.
And while we're all susceptible to the cold, Dr. Ellis says those most at risk are the elderly and the homeless. Michael?